Okay, this problem is another proof that you would find in a first semester course of linear algebra. It says, let B equal the set of four matrices listed here. Prove that B is a basis for M22R. Obviously, M22R is the notation for any 2x2 matrix with real values on all the entries. So, and this could be X, Y, Z, W. And those are just real values. To prove this problem, you basically just have to know the definition of what a basis is and prove that the given set forms a basis. So by definition, a basis spans whatever you're trying to form a basis of. So in this case, B has to span M22R, and also a basis, the span, whatever spanning it, has to be linearly independent. And by definition, if the values are linearly independent and they span in this case, a matrix, then it does form a basis. So if we do those things, we can prove this problem. The first thing I would do is to prove that B spans M22R. I would find the dimension first of M22R. So one way of thinking of dimension is, by definition, it's the number of matrices in this case that you need to form a basis. By definition, for matrices, the dimension of any M by N matrix is M by N. So in this case, because we have a 2 by 2, it's going to be 2 times 2 equal to 4. So the dimension of M22R will be 4, so you need a set of 4 matrices to span M22R and to form a basis. So, not coincidentally, we have 4 matrices here. The thing with dimension is that they do have to be linearly independent, so we haven't proved yet that the dimension of B is 4, but we can say because the dimension of M22R is 4, it suffices to show that B is linearly independent, because if B is linearly independent, then the dimension of B is 4, so then B will span M22R and be linearly independent, and by definition will be a basis. So now we basically prove that it spans M22R, more or less. Now we just have to show that the set B is linearly independent. So the way I would do that would just be putting coefficients and, you know, using the definition of what is linear independence. If you have C1 times matrix plus C2 plus C3 plus C4 equal to 0, and then you have to show that if you have a linear combination, the coefficients must be 0. Suppose C1, C2, C3, C4 exist in R, so these are scalars, then C1 times the first matrix plus C2 times the second matrix plus C3 times the third matrix plus C4 times the fourth matrix, and this is a 0 matrix. And just by matrix properties, we can rewrite that as C11, 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 plus, we're basically trying to show that if we have this linear combination, then the only solution will be the coefficients are 0, and that's a way of proving linear independence. So I'm just going to do that step by step. So C2, 0, 0, C2, plus 0, negative C3, C3, 0, plus C4, 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 negative C4 is equal to the 0 matrix. So if we combine across matrices, we're going to get C11 plus C2 plus C4, C1 minus C3 plus C4, C1 plus C3 plus C4, and C1 plus C2 minus C4 is equal to 0. Next, I would rewrite this as a linear system of equations. So C1 plus C2 plus C4 is equal to 0. C1 minus C3 plus C4 is equal to 0. C1 plus C3 plus C4 is equal to 0. C1 plus C2 minus C4 is equal to 0. We can rewrite this again in matrix form as 1, 1, 0, 1 is equal to 0. 1, 0, negative 1, 1 is equal to 0. 1, 0, 1, 1 is equal to 0. 1, 1, 0, negative 1 is equal to 0. If we let A be the coefficient matrix, so A is equal to 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, negative 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, negative 1, then we can do row reduction. So let's do R3 minus R1, R4 minus R1, and that gives us 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 1, 0, 0, negative 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, negative 2, and we're basically just trying to see if we get any 0 rows. Then we're going to do R3 minus R2, and that's going to give us 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, and 0, 0, 0, negative 2. So we can stop here because this is already in row echelon form, and we see that we're not going to get any 0 rows. So we can see that this is linearly independent. And we can go further and say A is invertible from the above. Thus, we can say, because we know that A was invertible, we had the equation A times the coefficients C1, C2, C3, C4 was equal to the 0 vector. We can say that A inverse times 0, 0, 0, 0 is equal to C1, C2, C3, C4, because we know A is invertible. Thus, we know that any matrix times zeros will give you 0, so we know that C1, C2, C3, C4 is equal to 0. So we've proved that B is linearly independent because B spans M22R and is linearly, let me write up LI, linearly independent. Thus, by definition, B forms a basis for M22R. And we're done with our proof.